1, 2, 3. Eins, zwei, drei. One, two, three.
It's okay.
Might help. No, there's no switch. There's still nothing. Ah,
yes.
It started to work. Can you hear me now? Great. Before we begin, is our Vietnamese speaker here? Is the Vietnamese shortlisted here? It seems that we are missing one of the shortlisted. No. Everybody is here. Great. So, please come to the stage and take your seat. All right, now I can breathe. Right, I am Harri Sahavirta, the chair of ENSLIP, Environment, Sustainability and Libraries section. And I wish to welcome you to the IFLA Green Library Award session. This is the occasion we are going to announce the winners for 2023. And I guess you can feel the excitement, at least among the shortlisted finalists who are sitting here on the stage. Environment, Sustainability and Libraries section is proud to present you IFLA Green Library Award. The award was established in 2016 and has been given every year since that. Detroit Publishing has been sponsored the award from the very beginning, and we thank you for that. The award has been a success. There has been so many submissions from all around the world, and the submissions have been so diverse that it was necessary to create two categories in 2021. At that point, the award was divided into two categories, the best green library and grant scale projects, and the best green library project, which gives the chance not only to brand new big library buildings, but also more modest short-term projects like environmental education projects for children. And indeed, ENSLIP wishes to encourage libraries to run innovative projects which take sustainability into account. We appreciate new openings where Green Library is not only the building, but includes green services and other activities, and which pay attention to environmental and social sustainability in a broad sense. And in fact, the United Nations SDGs are very important criteria for the award. But now, let us have a look at the submissions for this year, so I hand the microphone to Petra.
How can we open the slides? Okay, thank you. Yes, hello, my name is Petra Hauke. I'm from Berlin in Germany, and I'm the secretary of ANSELIP and involved with the team to organize the IFLA Green Library Award. Our time is strictly limited, so please allow me to refer to our website where you can find all relevant and also updated information about the award. The award is given in two categories, as Harri already said. Category one, the best green libraries or grand scale projects, and category two, best green library projects, especially for smaller libraries. The past winners from 2016 on, you can find them all on our website with their materials and presentations. And for example, you can find there also the Lviv Regional Children's Library from Ukraine, which was awarded in 2017. And if you visit their website, you will find they are still active, still active in ecology projects, and also to provide a secure and safe place for their children. Yes, in 2023, we received 28 applications from four continents, from Asia, North America, South America, and from Europe. And it was necessary to organize a pre-selection based on terms like the overall quality of the presentation and the project, and also regional diversity. But all dropped, primarily dropped submissions, and libraries were invited to come back again next year and to try it once more. Yes, after the pre-selection, we found 10 green library projects, and 9 green libraries or grand scale projects worth to be reviewed by our reviewer team. Our reviewer team is a large group. They come from Africa, Asia, Australia, North America, from Europe, and they are librarians from public and academic libraries, from library associations. There are LIS students, architects, former award winners, and so on. And we have developed criteria to be used by the reviewers for their reviewing process. And at the end, the reviewers found green library projects worth to be awarded as first or second or third place winner. Now this is just the alphabetic order. And also three worth to be awarded as best green library or grand scale project, coming from Colombia, Hungary, and Vietnam. And now it's still a secret who is the first place winner, the second and the third place winner. Yes, and here they are. Enjoy the short listed presentations. Let me come to the first one. And
hello,
now
everybody. My name
it's Malivan, your
librarian.
Part.
I'm a librarian at Villa Vallotton.
No?
Yes.
Hello, everyone. I'm very proud to, at least, you know, to pronounce the three finalists or shortlists. As you already see on the screen, let's now see the first shortlist. It is the Biblioteca Civica Villa Valley from Italy, with its project, the Seed Libraries. However, Marta Penso could not make it at Rotterdam, but she sent a video, so let's take a look.
Hello, everybody. My name is Allegra Razia, and I'm a librarian at Villa Valle Public Library. Our project is the Seed Library. It started in 2018 and it aimed to promote more awareness around soil health, active citizenship and biodiversity, as well as knowledge and respect for the environment. In our library, you can borrow up to 3 sachets of seeds to plant in a season. We ask that you plant the seeds at the right time, that when the plant has grown and has produced new seeds, you collect them and bring them back to the library. But we ask that you don't use synthetic products. The seeds are found in the public library in an allocated filing cabinet, which was also recycled. They are contained in sachets that specify the sowing and harvesting periods and whether the seeds are of a butterfly and a bee-friendly variety. There is also a paper and a digital catalogue containing specific information about the seeds we have and how to use them in your recipes and for home remedies. Besides, we selected books for children and adults about seeds, pollinating insects, and how to grow plants. The Seed Library organizes courses, walks, and workshops quite regularly. The local population shows a lot of interest in joining these activities, where they can share their knowledge and meet other people. Let's see some of these activities. Every spring we organize the Science Exchange. There's a day in March when people can swap branches to graft fruit trees, but they can also learn how to do it and how to then prune the trees. With gardening in the luggage, people learned how to grow a small garden with flowers and vegetables when you don't have a lot of space. The Seed Library also runs some workshops, for example, about wildflowers arrangements or about how to collect and preserve seeds. We organize walks such as a walk among ancient roses and like the bees from flower to flower, which tours the flowery meadows we promote. In some of the talks we promoted, we explored the Oriental gardens, how to support seed biodiversity, the origin of many fruits and vegetables and their domestication, GMOs and the role of soil life in food production. In 2021, we won the Cari Verona Foundation Format Grant, which allowed the Seed Library to organize some free courses on topics such as pruning, beekeeping for beginners, and organic food growing. The COVID-19 pandemic didn't stop us. During our first lockdown, some volunteers planted the seeds we had in order to create new plants and new seeds. When we reopened the library, we gifted users with the seed sachets, which you can see in some of these photos, showing the books they were reading and the plants born from the seeds. We have loaned about 653 sachets since 2018. In 2023, there have been 132 varieties of seeds available from the library. There are between 40 and 50 people who borrow plant seeds from our library every year. Our impact can be evaluated locally because we have officially made Valdagno butterfly and bee-friendly city. Nationally, we presented the project to all the libraries in our network and in some Italian cities, and now new seeds libraries are being born, but also globally because we have received seeds from different parts of the world. As a butterfly and bee-friendly city, we have been raising awareness about good green management practices and biodiversity among the local population. We promote public areas of flowering meadows that are attractive to bees and butterflies, and we have an educational beehive that we use for workshops we give to schools or to the general public. Our volunteers created flowering meadows close to several schools with the help of the children themselves, who made seed bombs and through them spread flower seeds. Children are indeed often involved in our workshops, because we believe that teaching good practices to the little ones is fundamental for them to become responsible adults. Our seed library is not the only one in Italy, but the way it's managed, the amount of people involved, and the quality of the events make us an innovative project. To promote it, we use Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, and Telegram. We also have a website and a newsletter, and it has all contributed to creating a wider network of passionate supporters. We also use printed press to spread the news in our local area. Many articles have been printed over the years about our activities, workshops, courses, the flowery meadows, the educational beehive, the activities dedicated to school children, and so on. We use QGIS to pinpoint and keep track of our flowery meadows, many beehives and bird houses in Valdagno. With our citizen science project in iNaturalist, we monitor pollinating insects in our local valley. Since 2022, we've registered more than 2,000 observations of pollinators. Seed library also means sustainability. Human, everyone involved has a skill to offer. Social, it's a community of people working together. Financial, it's not for profit, and it's mainly based on the volunteers' work and on the exchange of plant seeds, and it's focused on doing no harm to the environment. Looking at the UN SDGs, we promote sustainable agriculture, we fight against soil pollution, we pay attention to the quality of the contents we offer people, we have made the city safer and more sustainable, we ensure sustainable production patterns, and we promote sustainable use of the ecosystems against biodiversity loss. We really do believe in this project, since it is carried out with minimal resources, but has a big impact on the library, on the people, on the city itself, and a tiny little one on the world, or at least we hope so. Thank you for the attention.
The second finalist is from Korea, from the
As a representative
Seoul
Library
Metropolitan
of Seoul.
Library. Its project is Eco Project in Seoul Metropolitan Library for SDGs. We have a project presentation, and also Ms. Chair Eun Kim is with us. Please take a look.
And the presenter.
As a representative library of Seoul, Seoul Metropolitan Library has been in the forefront
Excuse
in improving
me,
environmental awareness for sustainable development. We exerted efforts to become a green library by carrying out various eco-projects inside and outside its facilities. From now on, I will explain the eco-project in Seoul Metropolitan Library. Seoul is making various efforts to spread a zero-waste lifestyle toward a sustainable and carbon-neutral city. Seoul Metropolitan Library is also striving to become an eco-friendly library in line with the city's vision. Seoul Outdoor Library Project is providing a unique experience with nature outside the library. The lobby of the library was refreshed with a green garden with purification plant to make a green space shared by citizens. In this garden, a music performance and a healing program were held to take care of citizens' mental health. Recycling bins were placed in the library so that citizens could separate recyclables from trash. In order to contribute to carbon neutrality, we recycled used banners into reusable bags and let the library users borrow when borrowing books. On a World Environment Day, we provided book curation service under the theme of Taking Care of the Environment in Extreme Weather and Climate Change. We strived to make Seoul Plaza an eco-friendly outdoor library, where citizens can freely enjoy book culture. The reason why we run an outdoor library is to provide citizens with a space where they can feel the importance of nature and the environmental crisis. Various reading programs and environmental events are also held in the plaza. Environmental crisis clock performance was held in Seoul Outdoor Library. Children and teenagers gathered to inform the seriousness of the climate crisis with the environmental crisis clock. Seoul's environmental crisis clock, which shows the environmental destruction crisis as a clock, indicates the danger level that passes 9 o'clock. Libraries not only provide people with knowledge, but also revitalize local communities. Seoul Metropolitan Library plays a role as a platform that provides library services that everyone could participate in. For this, we focus on achieving sustainable development goals and have achieved 11 of the 17 goals. We delivered a lecture to share the goal of ending poverty in all forms. Catholic priest Lee Moon-soo, who runs a restaurant that provides a reliable meal at a low price to people in financial need, delivered a lecture on the theme of "Don't let anyone stand on the brink." We want to raise the level of public interest in eradicating poverty through lectures. We run a yoga program in Seoul Outdoor Library for citizens' good health and well-being. Busy office workers took part in a yoga program during their lunch break to take care of their health. Children can play at the outdoor playground made of air bounce. For children, this is a place where children can play in a healthy way. Seoul Metropolitan Library organizes various library programs to provide parents with valuable information for their kids, such as how to raise children in the era of the Fourth Industrial Revolution, how to communicate to maximize children's potential, how to discipline children, and also heal mothers' hearts. Seoul Metropolitan Library provides pregnant women with information on childcare to support healthy childbirth and parenting. This project is one of the efforts of the Seoul Library to promote gender equality. We provide Arisu, healthy and eco-friendly water for library users. Drinking tap water is good for environment because the use of bottled water and water purifiers generates a lot of plastic waste and greenhouse gases every year. We provided tablet PC rental service so that e-books can be read on the grass. Using secure public Wi-Fi, citizens can use the library's e-book and audiobook services. It is an innovative service that allows users to rent tablets outdoors and read electronic materials. We strive to reduce inequality by providing services for the elderly and the disabled. We provide braille books, large print books, audio books, assistive devices for the disabled, so that everyone can enjoy reading. Easy-to-learn digital finance programs for 5060s provide seniors with changes to be educated on the use of mobile banking. We carried out the project Reading Together with One Theme. This reading campaign is Seoul-type business model of One Book, One City. This project aims to improve the competence of reading community by having a common cultural experience, reading the same book, and discussing each other on a single topic. In an action to respond to climate change, we have worked with environment-related organizations by strengthening network. Programs such as reading picture books on environment and making environmental kits were conducted for kids in our outdoor library. Seoul Metropolitan Library also joined Peace Light campaign to console the people of Ukraine suffering from the war and to spread the message of world peace against the war. It is a campaign to display blue and yellow lights symbolizing the Ukrainian flag and contains a message of world peace. Seoul Metropolitan Library will work harder in 2023 to contribute to achieving the 17 goals of SDGs by running programs that take the lead in environmental protection, and will continue to cooperate with various environmental organizations to inform citizens of the importance of the environment. We initiate environmental campaign to create a culture of continuous improvement for climate action. One of the campaign is to turn off the cooling system in each household and encourage people to visit Seoul's libraries in hot weather to save energy and reduce carbon emissions. 170 libraries in Seoul participates in this campaign. Librarians working at Seoul Metropolitan Library will continue to make efforts to fulfill our role as a green library, while considering environmental issues by emphasizing the importance of environmental protection in our daily lives through various projects. We will be at the forefront of moving toward a sustainable and eco-friendly society.
Thank you for watching our video. Thank you.
And the last library finalist for the best green library projects is the West Vancouver Memorial Library with its project Climate Writer in Resident at the West Vancouver Memorial Library with a novel solutions. Please be welcome Stephanie Hall to the stage.
Thank you.
Thank you. It is quite an honor to be here, my first IFLA with people from all over the world, these esteemed colleagues, and I'm taking notes on every presentation to take back to my country. And so thank you to Ensulib and the panel for this honor. But I must confess that as I'm speaking here today, part of my mind is back home in Canada, where our country and our forests are burning. Friends have fled their homes. A library that I once managed may have burned to the ground. So I think the climate emergency is very real for us all here today. And we are all connected in this emergency. The author, John Valiant, has written a book entitled Fire Weather. And he describes something he calls 21st century fire, where we are seeing different behaviors. Things we've never seen before are the new normal, and this will continue, he predicts. He also coined a term called the Pyrocene, which is describing our fossil fuel dependent society and era. And he describes it as time self-limiting, which I think, and it will be very short, which I think is accurate. So on the theme of forests, they are often referred to as the lungs of the planet, and I think it's an apt metaphor for the connection between all of us in this climate emergency. So talking about connections, I think library service in the 21st century is about helping our communities make connections, helping them synthesize information about complex issues. And all of the people here today have been doing an admirable job of that. Libraries help us make sense of difficult matters. In our library, we have a strategic framework that talks about four values: learning, community, inclusion, and integrity, and they're all connected, obviously. And within that integrity value, we have two themes of environmental sustainability and honoring reconciliation. So honoring reconciliation for us is about respecting the knowledge and the rights of Indigenous people and working to restore what has been lost or damaged. And the writer Lee Miracle had a great quote where she said, "I would always forgive someone who was standing on my foot if they got off my foot." So that is what we're trying to do. And within this project, our values, you will see, are entwined as well. Climate action is a long-standing theme for our library, coming from about 2006, and we have a number of different initiatives we've done. We had a community-generated climate action toolkit and a number of other such projects. Katlia Lafferty was our first climate writer in residence, and she's a member of the Yellowknives Dene First Nation. She was extremely generous to us and shared a wealth of knowledge. So this program really does connect multiple values for us. We do believe it's the first time we've seen a climate writer in residence in any public library, but I would like to acknowledge that we did see the idea come from Newcastle University and a poet named Linda France. And it's interesting that she and Katlia have maintained a correspondence together, and a forthcoming book will share their correspondence. The program did have also a tech component for children where they could contribute to an ebook, and that connects to an ebook publishing program that we have run for several years. The community-wide campaign included bus stops, ads, and we did have community cafes. In the previous slide, there was a photograph of, let's see if I can go back. Children with the buckets in the river, and I wanted to just describe that program, which is called Adopt a Fish. So each year with a local community group called Stream Keepers, they release fish into the river to replenish the stocks. And in the middle photograph, you see two women. One is Katlia, our writer in residence, and one is Chief Janice George of the Squamish Nation. Through this program, over 800 people actively engaged, and we had, Katlia was extremely generous in helping us connect with the Indigenous nations and also assisted them with a climate change planning session. Katlia will receive a literary book deal out of this collaboration, which is important to us because obviously any creative residency also has a goal of furthering the growth and development of the artist involved. We always include this handsome gentleman on a bicycle, but because we're in Netherlands, it seemed even more important to include him and a bit of community feedback about the project. We honor IFLA's work on connecting the SDGs to library work and in promoting it on a national agenda. Through the project, we work to connect our library collections and cultural groups from around our community to this initiative. One of the most exciting parts of the year was when Chief Janice George provided us with the gift of a name, a traditional name for our community garden, which is Swawe Temuh, which means it's a place name and it means of the land. This garden is an example of the adaptability of many libraries, and we've heard of a couple of other gardens. We have a number of components to it, and I wanted to mention that this slide is already out of date because we do have our bee hotel, and we lend an unusual collection, which is the bees themselves, as well as their homes. Within the garden, we received also the gift of a local indigenous children's school, recording all of the names of the native plants in the garden, and that can be accessed on our website or through, we're going to be installing QR codes throughout the garden. On the garden, we also offer numerous programs, concerts. Many people who are immune compromised have told us this is the first time that they can attend a group event because it's outdoors. We have repair cafes, and we have electric vehicle petting zoos, which have things from cars all the way to electric cargo bikes. The food is freely available to anyone who comes by, and we have children from nearby apartment buildings who come and take strawberries. We have a long history of environmental work, and if you'd like to see our green buildings operation policy, which dates from 2009, it's on our website. We hope this year to completely divest from natural gas, which will save about 70 tons of greenhouse gas per year, which we feel is important for our authenticity in trying to lead environmental education. I believe I'm out of time, but thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Congratulations to all three finalists for the Best Green Library Project. Now I would pass along to Amélie for the Best Libraries and Grand Scale Library Award, Green Library. And thank you. I'll give you to.
Yes, thank you, Malivan. Yeah. So it's Amélie from Switzerland, and it's my great pleasure and honor to be able to present the finalists of the category Green Libraries and Best Green Libraries, and Grand Scale Project. And the first finalist is the Vietnamese-German University in Seoul with its Inclusive Library for Sustainable Development project. And we have here Nguyen T. Kim Tri on stage to talk about this project. Thank you.
Run your here, okay?
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, hello everyone. It's my very great pleasure to be here to share with you about our inspiring and green library from Vietnam. So, Vietnamese German University Library is the new sustainable and state-of-the-art library to be the models for other Vietnamese library to learn and also for the region as well. especially the design of the library is linked to the whole green campus for energy conservation. And our green team for conducting HUA for acting for the sustainability. And you know that my story from here. So my story from the Australian study time where I learned how to develop a sustainable library with environmental protection awareness for our university and library. Is it the reason why I, the library director, is the co-founder of Green Inspiration Organization, developed the Seed Green policies, focusing on environmental protection actions and inspiration. So here is the team from our university, including mostly the university staff and also me on the picture. The first one is the policy reuse that focusing on call for actions and commitment from the university and our library users to commit with conducting the 3Rs initiatives, reduce, reuse, recycle. And you know that our library bring the whole nature, the whole green trees into the library and apply to the whole university and their offices to make the environment more inviting, more pleasant, more inspiring for working and for research and for learning for the communities. And our library's team also make endeavors to save papers, electricity, water, as well as the wide use of facilities, resources, the building, and also the public transport are intensively applied to achieve resource and energy reservation. And example, for example, for the library opening time, we open from Monday to Saturday. However, in the evening time until 10 p.m., we turn up the aircon system to sell the electricity. And especially for the summer break, where there are not many students, so we can control the aircon system to sell the electricity and energy. And you see that we also had a policy for the green bins. That means we promote the recycle program across the campus. As well as we had the bins for collecting e-waste and battery for disposal. So we bring to the Vietnam Tái Chế, that means recycle Vietnam for disposal. And especially, we show our social responsibility via the donation box that we bring the books and the unused clothes to the charity and to the remote area for the people who need. Yeah. And we also had a number of green knowledge sharing workshops and events to promote the environmental awareness and actions. And the design of the campus and the library is very beautiful with landscape. Yeah, and for energy conservation, AWA for environmental restoration and for ecological resilient capacity. And also, we also had a white water treatment for watering the trees, and water also come from rain storage, like and also underground. Especially the new campus with the new library here, effective control management system for aircon system and HVA, the sensor lighting. And we also have solar renewable energy to additional electricity output to expand the electricity and energy for the university. And the physical sustainability focusing and focusing on carbon footprint and resource consumption reduction, HUA, to reduce the emission from the library's daily activity from our users, especially the carbon handling for increased services and facility and resources are promoted and effectively implemented. We also provide the shared facility and material as a new share economy that results in cost and resource effectiveness. And we have a number of environmental activity like Green Monday, Green Market, recycle program, e-waste exchange, etc. And the library also apply for the SDG like number 5, 6, 10, 11, and 17 for our well-being and inclusive libraries. And also, we also focusing on which you read library principles as well with the four criteria. And the last one, but not least, we will develop the RIN Library Center for Vietnam that can be applied for other regions as well. Thank you for your listening. Sorry to take your time.
Thank you, Nguyen, for this wonderful presentation. And now I'm happy to announce the second finalist of this category, and it's Iyesh Gyula Library of Tolna Country in Hungary with the project Library at the Gates of Culture and Gemeins. And the speaker is Norbert Kovács. Welcome.
Thank you very much. First and foremost, this is an honor and a privilege to be here, and I have to thank for the panel to invite us, and I have to thank for the Hungarian Association and the Europe Direct Tolna the support to get me here. Okay. So, I am Norbert Kovács from Hungary. I'm representing the Iyesh Gyula Library of Tolna County. Our title is Library at the Gates of Cultures and Gemeins, and the red deer is because it symbolizes the town and the Gemeins forest. So, the geographical location of Szekszárd, Hungary is located in Central Europe in the Carpathian Basin. Tolna County is in Transdanubian region, and Szekszárd is the county seat. So Gemeins Forest is part of a national park, and it's quite famous for their deers. Gemeins are a unique floodplain forest, home of many highly protected species, and some famous writers born in Szekszárd, Mihály Babic and Miklós Mésző, whose green legacy is very utterly important for us. The town's cultural roots still stem from its proximity to nature. Okay, about the library, we are 31. We are a county library and a service library in 97 settlements of Tolna County Library Service System. Currently, we are residing in two old buildings. Well, it is what it is. And we established an eco-working group in 2020. Our mission, to support local green initiatives and create a safe, open environment in our community spaces for our existing clubs and new groups, for example, the Green Yarn, which is a readers' initiative, and the Library Creative Club. We approach sustainability with its complexity, and we set a network as a grassroots initiative at county and national level as well. Here you can see a photo of the first Hungarian Green Library Network Conference, which was held in Szekszárd 2022. Yeah. Okay, we provide opportunities to share green ideas, to learn and discuss environmental issues. We use various channels and tools to give up-to-date information to our readers, developing their critical thinking. Okay? The new eco-conscious building became the catalyst of our green library dreams, with solar panels, indoor green wall of air purifying plants, a green roof, a park, and a playground around the building characterizes the Saksard Knowledge Center. It is already ready. We just did not move in. We have an eco collection of documents on ecological thinking, nature, and environmental protection. And we set up eco shelves and green corner in both buildings, both in the main building and both in the children's library. In our green services, which were created in partnerships, we emphasize the importance of individual consumer choices, collecting waste cooking oil, electric battery, and cell phones. We have recycling bins, of course, and we organize penny book fairs. We are a donation point for bee and bird protection as well. We have a seed library. It supports eco-gardening, helps to preserve biodiversity. We organize seed fairs and seedling exchange actions promoted by the Hungarian Green Library Network. Okay, we are doing hikes. We organize nature walks with a community of nature lovers formed around the library, herpetological and botanical towns as well, town walks as well. We focus on natural heritage, local history knowledge, and promoting a healthy lifestyle. We are an animal-friendly workplace as well. On the left, you can see the most popular colleague of us, Shari, the library's cat. We keep snails in children's library. We have a bat roost, bird feeders and burrows, and an insect hotel as well. We regard social responsibility as part of sustainability, so we organize donations for the local dog shelter and for the children's ward of the hospital. And we have garbage collecting activities with cultural partner institutions as well. Networking together in Tolna County, we are greening of the library service system. We organize the county's green library cooperation with good practices, special documents, green programs, and green furniture. And we provide recycling actions, promoting a different kind of approach. So here is the timeline of the National Green Library. It's a quite fresh thing. The first conference was held in Saksa 2022. The second one was in this year in Tatabánya, and there were two events at the assembly of the Hungarian Library Association as well. Okay, environmental education is utterly important because children are multipliers for different generations. Book presentations, presentations, storytelling, interactive lectures, DIY with families are held in the children's library. We have a baby club and a bird-friendly club as well. Okay, for the youth, an enthusiastic colleague of us organized various clubs for the teens. We help them to become more responsible, environmental conscious adults living in harmony with nature. We help to integrate disabled young people as well, alleviating their isolation, improving quality of life, supporting community building in their residential home with storytelling, music, and dance. Okay. We are going to continue our work in 2024 in the new building on the basis of a new green strategy. And thank you for your kind attention.
Thank you, Norbert, for presenting your very inspiring project. And now I announce our third finalist, and it's Biblioteca EPM in Colombia with his project Education for Sustainable Development. And please welcome our speaker, Vivian Puerta.
Good afternoon. It is a great honor to be here in front of you representing the EPM Foundation, the EPM's library, but especially the wonderful team that made this nomination possible. I would like to start greeting Carolina Jaramillo, our program's director, who is here with us. She has the enormous responsibility to lead the whole ecosystem of sustainable experiences at the foundation. Also, I would like to say hello to Felipe Corrales, the leader of the library in Medellin. Diana Acevedo, responsible for the SDG Club. Edgar Montoya, responsible for the Robotics Club, among many others who are right now in Medellin online watching this by streaming. So I want to give you guys a very special greeting with love and gratitude to all of you. I can speak a lot about the work that we do at the EPM Library, but the time is very limited, so I invite you to follow us in our social media and also in our webpage if you want to go in detail of everything that we do in Medellin, Colombia. The EPM Library is part of the ecosystem of sustainable experiences created by the EPM Foundation 2 years ago, which our focus is precisely education for sustainable development. That's the reason why we have created several pedagogical strategies to take our message to more than 2 million people in the city. And regarding the library, more than 300,000 people who visit us each year. At the EPM Foundation, we work closely with UNESCO. We implement his initiative, the SDG Club, because we like and we want to promote the 2030 agenda, especially from the early ages. In this case, from children between the 6 and the 12 years old. How we do it? We do it in a very playful and experiential way. This has been an amazing journey to all of us. Actually, the name of the club is Journey to the SDG Country. So we don't just promote the lecture of books regarding SDGs. We call the action, we promote actions that go and impact to the SDGs in general. For instance, just last week, we have an amazing festival where kids from this club, they collect donations and they give it away to the people who need it. Likewise, we also have an educational and inclusive robotic club in which more than 4,000 children and young people participate, including kids with hearing and visual disabilities. We have a special lecture room called My Name is Earth. This amazing character is the first pedagogical content in our country that developed education on climate action. It is an innovative and disruptive strategy that is available to everyone. You can see the webpage right there, www.meyamotierra.com. There you will find the content, not just in English, but also in Spanish. So I assure you, you will love it. But we are not only in the city of Medellin. We contribute to the reduction of inequalities through our traveling library. This initiative goes to 19 public schools located in rural areas, exactly when that is needed the most. We take all our services, book loans, robotics classes, reading promotion, among any other pedagogical activities. Last but not least, At the library, we have clear actions to mitigate climate change. We have, of course, solar panels, so we use clean energy. And this clean energy produces the 39% than energy that we consume at the building. We also have changed the lighting to LED technology, which, of course, has allowed us to reduce the energy consumption. And we have a solid waste management plan with a circular economy component. The commitment of our library goes beyond reducing its environmental footprint. It includes the promotion of ecological awareness among our collaborators and our users. The main objective is to inspire them to adopt responsible behaviors with the planet in their daily life and their community. At the EPM Foundation, we strongly believe in the importance, the power, and the role of the libraries and the librarians as promoters of the 2030 agenda and their ability to play a leading role in the education for sustainable development. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Vivian, for presenting your amazing library and its projects. And now we are all thrilled to know the final ranking and who are the winners. And please welcome Harri and Priscilla to present the winners.
Thank you. We have now heard the six shortlisted submissions. And as you see, sustainability lies, penetrates everywhere in libraries. They've been from different different countries, different continents, very different projects and buildings. As you see, we really do need at least two categories. And I think that you can also imagine that the reviewers have had hard work to evaluate these submissions. But yes, I think we now have to go to the winners. Maybe we start with the projects. We are going to announce the winners now and give you some reasons afterwards. So, the winners for the best project are: first place, Canada, West Vancouver. Congratulations. But I hand the microphone now to Priscilla, who is given some reasons why these submissions were selected.
Hello all, good afternoon. My name is Priscilla Poon from Macau. I'm the information coordinator of the Environment, Sustainability and Library sections of IFLA. So the first winner from Canada, yes, the reason is below. This project truly deserves to be awarded for its innovative contribution that combines literature and climate in a unique way of creating programs of education for sustainable development that involve the entire community through a variety of events. In addition, effective energy saving measures led to a greener design of the library itself. Finally, the program not only has a positive impact on a significant number of its local users, but can also serve as a model for other libraries around the world. Congratulations. Please come on the stage to receive the award.
Yes. Okay, and please stay here for the next ones.
Finish? Yes. Oh, the second place is from Biblioteca Civica Villa Valle, Italy, with the title The Sea Library. So the reviewers have some comments on that is below. This project truly deserves to be awarded as the idea of the sea library takes on a new dimension. It influences the city's decision to become more bee and butterfly friendly. By involving customers in decision-making processes, long-term effects on sustainable community engagements have been achieved. The program can serve as a role model for other libraries around the world, no matter whether they are large or small. Congratulations.
Anna is a standing committee member of ENSULIP and takes the document instead of the winner who is still in Italy. Okay.
Thank you. And the third prize goes to Seoul Metropolitan Library, Seoul Rep, Korea, with the title Eco Projects in Seoul Metropolitan Library for SDGs. This project truly deserves to be awarded as a green library for their comprehensive submission with good storytelling. The submission describes how the library, with its focuses on 11 SDGs, is driving the way they operate towards net zero, as well as educating citizens on net zero. Citizens were encouraged to follow suit with many interesting events and workshops for people of all ages, along with lectures, cooperation programs, and collections on the environment. The program can serve as a role model for other libraries, no matter where they are, public or academic libraries. Congratulations. Thank you.
Now we come to the best green libraries or grand scale projects. And the winners are, for the first place, Colombia, for the second, Hungary, and for the third, Vietnam.
Right, let us start with Colombia. The winner for the best library. This project truly deserves the Green Library Award, demonstrating that sustainability is at the heart of the strategy and embedded in all the activities, storytime programs, lectures, robotics, new technology, and business development. Through their sustainability education, they demonstrate that the goal of continuous improvement over time is what they value. A great initiative in a low middle income country. Congratulations. Right, and let's go to Hungary next. This project truly deserves to be awarded as it demonstrates a strong community commitment that includes several partnerships with local, national, and international organizations. An impressive aspect is their commitment to collaboration and learning about sustainable initiatives from other libraries around the country, enable the growth of a countrywide green library network. Worth noting, the library also has set sustainability issues as a core of its mission statement. And my congratulations. Now we have a Vietnamese German University Library. This project truly deserves to be awarded as a Green Library through its internally designed, energy efficient, symbolic building closely linked to the campus. A committed team also effectively implements action programs to promote sustainability as part of an overall strategy. An example that deserves to be disseminated worldwide. And my congratulations again. I wish to congratulate all the winners once again. You have done a great job, and I do wish you continue the sustainability work in the future too. I also thank our audience who has come here to listen about these great projects and buildings. And I wish to remind you that there will be the next IFLA Green Library Award for the year 2024. We shall not skip decades next spring. All right, so if you're interested, if your library does good work on sustainability, if you're committed to the United Nations SDGs, why wouldn't you leave a submission and try? It's a great game. It has learned us very much when we've been reviewing the submissions. And it's so great to see that sustainability counts all around the world in so many libraries, some with big budget, big plans, big visions, some very modest resources, but doing some remarkable work. And I think the winners might like a photographic session next, so maybe we end the official session here. Thank you once more.
Thank you.
You said that absence makes the heart.
Keep on doing what you do, never give up believing.